students, we have already discussed the lesson discovering that the saga continues. The line by explanation, passage to passage, all important details we have discussed. Today I will give some hints of the important questions, textual questions, and you have to go through the text insightfully, think about all the questions and then answer in your own words. Page number 28, understanding the text. So here, question number first, give reasons for the following. You have to give the reasons in that King Tut's body has been subjected to repeated scrutiny. So why does King Tut, that body, it was repeatedly set for the investigation, scrutiny? We have to provide the reason. What was the reason? Here in this question, you can refer some points. In that, the first important thing it is, there was a question mark, or we can say that still, what was the reason of his death, that nobody knows. Here we have to think about the followers, everyone. So they were also in the same thing, and in the beginning itself, it is referred that he was just a teenager when he died. So why he died at the age of very early, means in teenage age group? Then one of the thing it is, the last heir of powerful family that had ruled Egypt, its empire for countries, and he was not a common man. So he was the last heir of the powerful family in the Egypt, and we have already discussed the family tree, everything. Again, one more thing here, it is mentioned about some scientific important things, in that Tut has undergone a CT scan that offers new clues about his life and death, provides precise data for an accurate forensic reconstruction of boy's pharaoh. So here, for the sake of forensic reconstruction, for the sake of forensic analysis in special designed forensic labs, when they will go through that, means X-ray, other also nowadays new techniques it is developed, and in that new techniques also we can go and investigate. So here in this lesson, X-ray and CT scan machine, the two important diagnostic tools, here it is mentioned, scientific way they will do it. So here the reason, what was the reason why repeatedly, means here two references we can give. In that two references, first, page number 25, that one reference it is there. In 1968, more than 40 years after Carter's discovery, an anatomy professor x-rayed the mummy and revealed a startling fact. So here we have to provide the reason that when they were started investigating and they were started thinking scientifically to reveal the mystery, what was the mystery behind his death, early death? So here, this also you can mention, that through that, beneath the regions that cracks his chest, his breastbone and front ribs are missing. So here, through this we can clearly understand that what would be their motto. Their motto to understand that what was the cause. And two more again things here it is mentioned. Same page, page number 25. That it could answer two of the biggest questions still lingering about him. Still, it is there in the mind of the people. What is that? How did he die and how old was he at the time of the death? So here, basic thing you can understand. So the demand of the question is, the King Tut's body has been subjected to repeated scrutiny. The reason would be that everybody, they were thinking to find out the reasons that they wished to think about what was the mystery behind his death and the age. All things about his death, they wished to know more. So, in brief, you can answer. Then, Howard Carter's investigation was resented. Means here, feel bitterness. The reason here, what would be the reason? Here, Carter also, he had also investigation, but I will refer one important quote from the lesson. Through that you can understand. The mummy is in very bad condition because of what Carter did in the 1920s, said Zahi Hawass, Secretary General of Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities. So here this Zahi Hawass, he made one statement, and what is that statement? That is, the mummy is in very bad condition because here Carter had not taken care, proper care and proper tools. Means when someone is investigating, here in the lesson there is one word it is mentioned, and what is that one word? That it contains through harshly ransacked in antiquities. So this ransack also means he used the investigating tools and all things very roughly. So the thing it is, we can feel it is resented. You can mention more reasons. Some clues I have given to you. Then Carter had to chisel away the solidified resins to raise the king's remains. So here again we have to find out what would be the reason, and that reasons are given. Page number, you can refer 23rd and 25th also. So here what would be the reason you can mention? When finally when he finally reached the mummy, though he ran into trouble, the ritual resins had hardened, cementing Tut to the bottom of his solid gold coffin. So this type of care, it was already taken by the Egyptians. And that important thing we can mention here, that it was very specific thing it is mentioned. So it was not possible for the Carter to take out that things easily. So here the question it is, Carter had chiseled away the solidified resins to raise the king's Tut. Then what was the one more thing here we can mention? So it is given here, no amount of legitimate force could move them, Carter wrote later. So here it cannot be moved easily, because what was the reason? Here reason is, the ritual resins had hardened, cementing Tut to the bottom of his solid gold coffin. And then one more here effort we can mention, that what was the effort? The sun can beat down like hammer this far south of Egypt, and Carter tried to use to lose the resins. And Carter had taken one more important here step, and what was that? If scientifically he was thinking here for several hours, he set the mummy outside the blazing sunshine that heated it to 149 degree Fahrenheit. Nothing budged, and again he was here confessing that nothing moved, nothing changed, because it was too much hardened. And then he had taken the decision, and that decision it is to chisel away all the things. So here, as per the demand of the question, I have given just the references, that references you can refer and you can write the answer. Then Tut's body was buried along with gilded treasures. So here you can refer page number 23, and in that so many things here referred, and that is referred as a funerary treasures. In the earlier passage also there is one important terminology it is used, and what is that terminology? They remain the richest royal collection ever found and have become part of Pharaoh's legend. The stunning artifact is gold. Their eternal brilliance means to guarantee resurrection. So here resurrection means new beginning for something which is old. And here Egyptians, they believed when means afterlife. So there is a faith in that concept, resurrection. So that here caused a sensation at the time of the discovery and still get the most attention. But the Tut was buried with everyday things he would want in the afterlife. And here things also mentioned, the board games, bronze razor, linen undergarment, cases of food and wine. So here, why? Because they believe in the resurrection. So this is the important reason you can mention. Your question, it is not asked that what is the funerary treasure or what was included. Here it is asked about the reason. So you have to give your reason. Then one more thing, it is why here it is mentioned as a gilded treasures, because one more reason you can mention that they were fabulously wealthy, and as per the status of the king, they have to keep all the things of gold, because they wish to show that after the death also he is carrying the same thing, that richness, everything, and it was their belief. So as per their tradition, as per their ritual, as per their funerary norms, procedures, so it was given. Then next you can mention that the boy king changed his name from Tutankhaten to Tutankhamun. So here the boy king, so who was that boy king? So here finally we got the name for that boy king, that is Tutankhamun. So you have observed that Tutankhamun's documentary, BBC documentary also. So why that young pharaoh, young boy or young king, he changed his name when he had taken the responsibility? The reason already it is there in the earlier passage, And what is that reason? I will refer the page for you. Page number 25. Reference, it is given about the Amin Hotep, third, and Amin Hotep, fourth. So in that Amin Hotep fourth, when he succeeded, what he had done? He had taken the decision. And what was that decision? That he changed his name. And what was the change? The change was the concern with the God. And his name, it is here mentioned, Akhenaten. So he changed his name as Akhenaten, and he changed his the whole system, religious system. In that, here a new pharaoh promoted the worship of the Aten, the sun disk. So he had promoted that worship of the sun disk. And one more bad evil thing here he had done, and that is he started smashing. So here the reference it is given. He further shocked the country by attacking Amun, a major god, smashing his images and closing his temples. So here, this is the main important thing. And again, one more thing he had done, that is moved the religious capital from old city of Thebes to the new city of Akhenaten. So here, this means all the things concerned with the religious thing, and there was a faith on the major god Amun. So the citizens, they were having the faith on the major god, but now he started doing that evil thing, wrong thing, that is to smashing the images of major god Amun and again closing the temple. So when this young king, young pharaoh, he had taken the throne, he changed that. Means how earlier it was Amenhotep third, then Amenhotep fourth. So now it is Akhenaten. But that name will be as it is. But he had taken decision now that Aten should not be there, there should be Amun. So he had taken the decision. He wanted to restore all the things as earlier it was there. So here we can mention the same thing, and there is one line, oversaw a restoration of old ways. And he had given again the same thing, same facility to everyone to worship the major god Amun. And here it is mentioned, that is, he changed his name, and that was the name, living image of Amun. And he was now the angel, he was now the messenger of that major god Amun. And again that same faith, belief, it was there. And so here the Egyptians, they have the special space in their heart, understood about this young king. And so they were, I mean, still so many people, they are still thinking about what would be the cause of his death. So at least here the reasons you can mention about the earlier king. So he had taken that decision. Means he wanted to restore all that religious things again as it was before. Then second, list the deeds that lead Ray Johnson to describe Akhenaten as wacky. Wacky means here he was doing such a funny evil thing, and it will not be praised by anyone because that is the wrong thing. Deeds means his actions, wrong things. So what he had done, that just now in earlier question I have discussed. Okay, he changed his name as Amenhotep IV to the Akhenaten. Then one more here task he had done, he changed the religious capital, the Thebes, to the Akhenaten, that city. So here now known now as a Amarna, means Thebes to the new city of Akhenaten. One more thing, the bad thing he had done, that is the major god, Amun. And he started, and that was the shocking for everyone, that he started smashing the images of major god Amun. And one more, he closed the temples also. So here, if somebody would observe this, surely one more statement it is given about that Ray Johnson, that is, it must have been a horrific time. So he mentioned that it is the horrific time, and again the one word that is wacky also it is used. So here it is asked about this word, that is wacky. Why? Because he was not thinking properly. He was not thinking about the citizen. He was not thinking about the faith, belief of the people in that Egypt. He was behaving like a dictatorship. Means whatever he will think, he will do. He will not have any feeling, emotion for any person, sympathy, no, nothing. So he will just proceed with his power, that with the soldiers, everyone. He will do the wrong thing in that society. Then, next question. What were the results of the CT scan? So now here it is asked about the results of the CT scan. So here page number 26. So they have given some details. That details we can refer. A CT scan machine scanned mummy head to toe. And what was the here mentioning? Creating 1700 digital X-ray images in cross section. That's head scanned in 0.62 millimeter slices to register its intricate structure. Takes array details of resulting images. And one more, what here, what is the special thing it is mentioned, and that is the with that's entire body similarly recorded, and it is not only one person but a team of specialists in radiology, forensics, anatomy began to probe secrets that wing, goddesses and gilded burial shrines protected for so long. So here Zahi Abbas, he was not alone, but the special team of radiology, forensics and anatomy, all they were there togetherly. It was the team effort. Here only Zahi Hawass as a leader, he was leading the team, but they have taken care, more care about that. And then one more here we can observe. Other images revealed hand, several views of ribcage and transection of skull. So this also here, after the analysis, after the scientifically observation, that using the pixel quality, all things they have done, means the scrutiny. Neck vertebrae appear as clearly as anatomic class. Or here all the details about that it is given, page number 27. So you can refer that also. So what were the results of the CT scan? In that is enough. Then next question. List the advances in technology that have improved forensic analysis. So here earlier, here it is, we can mention that only our eyes or just the touch feeling, means using, now we are saying that vaidya or doctor or some, just using our hand or sensation, we cannot observe what is happening inside. So suppose we wish to analyze the internal body, what is, suppose there is a defect in any part of the body, then suppose any accident happens, then suddenly if there is a crack or something, we may go and we may do the x-ray of that part. Immediately we can understand where is the crack, and then doctor can give advice or suggest according to the diagnostic tools. So x-ray machine. Then, but x-ray has some limitations. Then again, advanced technology, that is CT scan machine, and here computed tomography it is used. So using that, what is the here important thing, it is mentioned about that today diagnostic imaging can be done with computed tomography or CT, by which hundreds of x-ray in cross section are put together like slices of bread and create a three-dimensional virtual body. So here three-dimensional picture of the body we can get it. So here that advances through that, this is the proper advantage for scientific process or forensic labs. All that things are equally important. So forensic reconstruction, when we are doing the scrutiny of the body, scientifically when we are trying to do that, then such type of things are here important. Then some again more things mentioned, page number 29, in that working with words, second CT scan, MRI, tomography, otoscopy, dialysis, ECG, postmortem, so here biospy, angiography. So all that words here used, and that words all are related with the advanced technology. So using all that advanced technology, we can save the life of the person. We can help, or we can get the earlier also some important details, historical also, suppose something we wish to investigate, then DNA test. So using all that things, we means criminals also, in criminal cases also, we can take the help of such type of advanced technology, and using that our CBI department or those who are the investigating teams, they are taking judgments or the final findings are with the help of such type of advanced technology. So here you can refer that. List the advances in technology that have improved forensic analysis. So in this you can two, three things about X-ray you can write, about CT scan you can write, and other also MRI, ECG, all concerned with that you can write. Means what would be the cause of death? Means suppose if any death occurs, then what was the medicine it was given to him? Was the dose proper? So according to the skin, all things they are observing in that postmortem report, and then forensic also report, they will again analyze that things. So you can refer this. Then understanding the text in that last question, explain the statement, King Tut's is one of the first mummy to be scanned in death as in life. So here it is referred, we can refer here page number 26. The King Tut is one of the first mummy to be scanned in death as in life, moving really ahead of his countrymen. So that next line is important, that moving ahead of his countrymen. So here also he is taking the leading. So many mummies were there. It is here mentioned that regardless of his fame and speculations about his fate, the Tut is one of one mummy among many in Egypt. How many? No one knows. Means so many mummies were there. So we we can think about that. So here, the Egyptian mummy project, which began an inventory in late 2003, recorded almost 600 as far and is still counting. So here we can observe that as a leader, he had taken again the responsibility to go ahead and face the situation. And he was, in this case also, he was the first. Means when he was there alive, that time also he had taken the decision. And what was that decision? To change his name as a Tutankhamun. So what was the earlier name? Earlier name, it was concerned with the god Aten. Afterwards, he had taken decision and again he was thinking to restore all the things. And he had given the fate to everyone. There will not be any such type of thing will happen that it will harm your things, or we can say that emotions, feelings of religious things, it will not be disturbed. So you can worship the god or major god, the Amun. Here in this lesson, so many important concepts are mentioned, and in that concepts we can observe that there are some rituals, traditions or funerary procedures, and the priest, all things. So here it is mentioned. Understanding the text questions, now we have discussed. In next video we will focus on the talking about the text, and some other also questions we will refer. Thank you. What is your important thing you have to do? Read the lesson carefully and accordingly try to mention all the details and complete that question answers in your notebook.